Hello, Highlevelers, Ray Daniel here. And in this video, what I really want to do is try to help out people who are new to GoHighlevel understand what GoHighlevel SaaS or what SaaS means. Again, you hear this term a lot and people think it's really cool. They tie SaaS to companies like Netflix and Spotify and all these other companies, and you know that SaaS is the new, best, greatest thing. But I want to sit back and just help those people out again who are just starting out with Highlevel understand what SaaS means. So first of all, what is SaaS? It stands for Software as a Service, which again ties into Netflix and Spotify because that's what they do. Typically, software as a service, you actually provide a monthly subscription service where people can basically rent or subscribe to your service. And as long as you keep paying every month, you can keep using the software. Just like, for instance, Netflix, you keep paying your whatever $20 a month and you get, you log in with your email address and password and you get streaming services according to them, and you keep getting streaming services as long as you keep paying. Now, how does the software as a service really relate to Highlevel and being able to build a software as a service company? Let's just take a step back for just real quick. Typically, let's just take Netflix because we've already been talking about them. In order for Netflix to really start selling their service, they had to build the entire video streaming platform that you see. They had to build like where to store all the videos, which ones are coming out, how to display the videos, all the apps that come out and all the smart TVs and the phones. They had to build all of this infrastructure to make it easy for people to just say, oh, click on the Netflix app, put in your email address and password, and then wow, you get all of these choices that are designed and you can pick whatever movie you want, search for whatever movie you want, and there it is. Now, what do you think it took for Netflix to build that? You know, I'm not gonna go over it, but let's just say it took a lot of money and several years of development in order to come up with that particular infrastructure and business model in order to sell it. Now, you guys don't have that time or the money. I know I certainly didn't. So right now, how can you get started with software as a service, specifically dealing with small businesses, which is what the GoHighlevel platform is? How can you get started with that very quickly? So when we refer to SaaS, really what we're talking about is GoHighlevel's ability for them to allow you to white label their software. Now, again, let me sit back and help you understand white labeling. White labeling is where you can put your logo on the page. You can have your custom website URL on the page. So really what it is, it looks like your software. So it is designed by Highlevel, supported by Highlevel. All of the infrastructure is, again, behind the scenes, Highlevel is taking care of all of that. What they're allowing you to do is saying, hey, buy our software, again, subscription service, buy our software, and then we will allow you to do all these cool things and have all these cool tools, and we'll allow you to put your logo on it, and we'll allow you to sit back and use your custom URL, custom link, custom domain is what that is, to sell this out. So really it looks like your brand and your software, even though we created it, we paid hundreds of millions of dollars, whatever it is, to build this platform, and we're gonna keep updating features, which, by the way, every new feature release and feature update that Highlevel comes out with, you will get that. So this is really what you mean when it comes to software as a service, especially with Highlevel. They're allowing you to just simply purchase their software. Now, there are a couple of different plans that you can purchase from, and I'll go over those briefly here in this particular video, but you can purchase the plan, and based upon the plan, they give you certain freedoms or ability to do things. But I think with GoHighlevel, even their best plan, you know, the sort of Mac Daddy, the Cadillac of all their plans, is honestly super cheap every single month for you to sit back and go out and build a business, use their software, put your logo on things, and then use your own custom domain inside of their software as well. So right now, what I'd want to do is just show you how you can utilize the software and how some of the features works at the different pricing points and the different pricing plans. So let's go ahead and hop into it here. Okay, right now what I'm doing is I pulled up just the Highlevel pricing plans. So I'm going to start with those first. I'm not going to spend a lot of time here, but I do want to show you some of the benefits that you get with each particular plan. Now, with this, if you just want to search for GoHighlevel pricing, you pull up the same page here. So this isn't anything hidden. This is open to the public. But there are three plans right now: 97, which is called the starter; 297, unlimited; or SaaS Pro, which again is the Mac Daddy one, the one I talked about earlier, for $497 a month. Now, with this, here's some of the features that you can deal with. First of all, if you are a small business and you're looking to utilize GoHighlevel for your own small business, and that's the only thing you're looking to do, I always recommend the $97 plan. You don't need any more than that. Regardless of what other people try to sell you, don't fall for it. The $97 plan is good enough. It allows you, again, some of the features when it comes to white labeling and SaaS. For those people who do want to start a software service agency, you can start out with a $97 plan, but here are some of the limitations. Number one, the cost is less, so that's not really a limitation, it's a benefit, but with the reduction of that cost, with that low quality cost, what you also get is higher time that you have to use when it comes to configuring clients. Now, here's some of the things that you get with the starter plan. You get the ability to use your own custom domain. That's available on all three plans. Now, what you don't get at the starter plan is you don't get the ability to customize your own logo, okay? Keep in mind, inside of the $97 plan, you will always see this Highlevel logo here. Let me blow this up. This little logo right here at the top, these little three arrows, this is pretty typical. This is the Highlevel sort of logo branding. that you end up seeing, you will get this logo at the top left of your screen here. And I'll show you what that looks like here in just a little bit when we take a look inside of the Highlevel platform. But you don't have the option to do that. At $97, you don't get the option to brand it as your own company, but you do get the ability to change and have a custom domain that people can log into. Now, you might not care about this in the very beginning, because right now, one of the other limitations that the starter plan has is that you're only allowed 3 sub-accounts. Now, what is a sub-account? A sub-account is an actual location or a business that can actually operate inside of the GoHighlevel platform. So you're only allowed 3 of those. Now, when you go to the unlimited plan here or the SaaS Pro, you get an unlimited number of sub-accounts. You're not limited by any of the sub-accounts at all. The whole purpose of these 3 sub-accounts on the starter plan is just so that you can get in cheaply to the software with a very low cost. You can use one of the sub-accounts for your own business, because you're gonna have to have funnels, websites, email marketing, text marketing, phone numbers for texting, receiving calls, and all that other kind of good stuff for you to do business. Now, if you're a small business, again, you're just gonna be using one for your own sub-account, and that's really it. You're not gonna be using the other ones because you're just using it for your own business. But if you're looking to grow and start a SaaS business, you can use the other 2 accounts actually as client accounts and start charging people $200, $400, or even more dollars per month, depending upon the services and Highlevel that you're gonna be providing to them, and of course, supporting. Now, support is another very good question. Inside of here, when you're doing SaaS mode, you are again supporting everybody that you bring on board. That's one of the things that a lot of my affiliates, when they sign up under my link, by the way, if you haven't signed up for Highlevel, or you're looking to upgrade, use my affiliate link below. I do appreciate it. I get compensated by Highlevel, but that's just my little plug. But a lot of my affiliates sit back and get started with the starter plan. And right now, one of the things about it is that there is a lot of manual process inside of the starter plan, meaning that whenever you get somebody to sign up, you do have to manually create their account. You have to manually create their user account. You have to manually assign security to the users, depending upon the features you want to give them and not give them. This is just a limitation. Again, you're in cheap at $97 a month, but you're going to quickly be able to get 1 or 2 customers. And then from there, you're going to start making enough money from those other 2 customers that you get for the other 2 sub accounts that now you can upgrade directly to Agency Pro, which is my preferred migration path. I don't necessarily like to go into the $297 plan, just because there is still some manual things in there regarding billing and stuff like that. And you don't have the ability to rebill and make some additional money, which I'll go over in just a little bit here. But there are just some limitations that I don't personally care for at $297. So I say go to $97 and then go right up to $497 if possible. That way you can use all the bells and whistles and all the automation tools inside of Highlevel to really get your SaaS business up and going. So right now, these are the 3 plans. Again, with the unlimited and the SaaS Pro, you can use your own custom domains, and you can brand it with your own logo, which makes it look like your own software. Now, the biggest things between the unlimited and the SaaS Pro is the SaaS configurator. Now, the SaaS configurator is the bomb diggity. It is the best tool that you can actually have if you're looking to build a SaaS business. Why do I say that? Because the SaaS configurator is the main tool that integrates all of the plans that you plan on selling. Once you get to a point where you actually say, here are the different plans that people can buy from me. Here's the $200 plan, the $400 plan, the $600 plan. You can have up to 20 different plans inside of the SaaS configurator. And here's the cool thing about this. Once you get the SaaS configurator built, the SaaS configurator and those products integrate directly with your Stripe or your other payment processor. So those products are automatically created and now available for purchase. You can build a funnel, which, by the way, if you sign up for me as an affiliate, I give you a whole sales SaaS funnel that you can completely build out what I'm talking about here. But inside of your funnel, you can actually have multiple different pricing plans. They put the pricing plan, they buy the plan, they sit back and then can sign up using their credit card. Their account automatically gets created inside of the Highlevel system. Their user account gets created. All of their user security, depending upon the features within that plan they have access to, are automatically done, created, and they get emailed right away. Now, let me just help you understand the power of that. Right now, let's just assume it is a Saturday morning at 10 o'clock a.m. in the morning, and you want to take the weekend off. You run a SaaS company, but your website, your funnels, your marketing, your Facebook ads, Google ads, all that marketing is still out there up and going. People find your page, people find your funnel. They're like, man, this is cool. This thing is awesome. I didn't know about Highlevel. Let me go ahead and sign up. So they can go to your funnel, click sign up for your SaaS program. Again, this is with Agency Pro. You cannot do this with the unlimited. So with Agency Pro, you can sit back and have a funnel. They can choose that particular pricing plan. You have an order form that will allow them to purchase that. And again, they can purchase a monthly plan, or you can even charge them for the whole year up front, right on the same order form. That's super cool too. So anyway, once they purchase that, then the SaaS configurator and Highlevel will automatically create their account, automatically create their user account, their security. And then within a few minutes, they're going to get an email saying, hey, your new account's created. Click here to get logged in. And from there, they can begin utilizing the software. And of course, you're going to want to, at that point, have some automations built in to do strategy calls and things like that afterwards. But the cool thing about it is with the unlimited plan, this one here in the middle, you can have a funnel built, but once somebody submits their order, somebody still has to manually go create that account, manually assign security and things like that. You don't get the automation with that. So that's one of the things, again, that you end up losing. And the biggest reason, again, pay attention here. The biggest reason why I say don't go to the 297 plan, go to the 497 plan, is because the agency pro, the 497 plan here, once somebody signs up, all of the billing is done automatically from Highlevel from every single month. They have a credit card. When they signed up initially, they use a credit card. That credit card will be charged for their monthly subscription, which whatever plan you're charging them, again, $200, $400 a month, that plan will be charged every single month on their renewal date. And they'll also be charged for all of the usage they've had. Keep in mind with Highlevel, there's a subscription, which is paying for the monthly service, but then the client, your clients, also have to pay for texting, email, calls in and out, AI, all of the other features inside of Highlevel, and even some automation features. There's some automation pieces that are in here, but again, Highlevel is making it easier to combine all the services together. But anyway, all that billing at the unlimited plan here, this one here in the middle, has to be done manually. You know, you have to manually figure out how much they did, how much they charged, and then bill them manually for that, and then wait to be paid every month. That is very frustrating, okay? Because now you're waiting to get paid. Here in the agency pro plan, their credit card is just charged through the payment processor every single month. You know, their subscription, all their usage fees, and any of the rebilling, meaning you can upcharge at the agency pro level, this SaaS pro, you can upcharge how much you charge them for email texting. So you can make a little bit of money off each one of your clients every time they utilize the services built into Highlevel. So that's pretty cool. So right now, this is another feature of SaaS Pro. And for just $200 a month, I know $200 a month for some people is a lot, but just dealing with the accounting and the billing alone, you cannot hire a bookkeeper for $200 a month to do all the bookkeeping and updating that the SaaS Pro account gives you by default. And guess what? You can even have it inside of your SaaS configurator where if their credit card is denied, then their whole account is paused. Pause meaning they cannot log into it. When they do log into it, they say, there's a problem with your credit card. Please contact your provider, which of course is you, the SaaS provider, to get the billing issue resolved. Now, typically this is when the credit card is expired or something like that, but that stuff can be done automatically. And of course, if they can't access the system and things like that, then they're going to contact you because that's how they do business. So anyway, those are the three plans and some of the pros and cons. I did want to sit back and show you inside of here. This is the Highlevel. I'm in my agency settings here. But this little logo, if you look at the top right here, I know this is not very big, but this right here is my custom logo and brand. And this is where it would show. Now, if you're on the $97 plan, this is where you would get the little Highlevel logo. These little logos right here would be up here in the corner. But this right here, if you come to your company settings, you just simply upload a new logo. It tells you what sizes the image should be right here, just to make it easier for you. Upload that. And then now your company logo is here. When people log in to your custom domain, which again, I'll show you where that is, you can simply have the logo here. And then when you scroll down here, there is an area right here inside of Highlevel where you can put in a white label domain. This is where your custom domain that people can go to. And really when it combines with the branding, really looks like your own software. Now, I will tell you this right here, I'm not using on this page, you know, anything specific. There are other tools that you can buy. And again, you can just simply search for this, but there are other tools out there that you can really customize the entire look of the GoHighlevel system to brand it to your colors. I'm not going to go over that. There's some other videos I have on my channel for how to customize the look and feel of the GoHighlevel system. So you can check those out. But this is ultimately what you would do to get your white label set up and to begin doing business as, you know, as a SaaS company. Now, one of the things I do want to show you here is in the SaaS configurator. This right here is where I showed you is where this is the best tool ever that Highlevel has come out with, and they're making this even better. But this right here is where you basically put in all of your plans that you have. So these right here are just how you charge. These little icons right here are all the different features that you offer inside of it. I'm just going to quickly come over here and just show you some of the things. Plan details. This is where you put in just the information about the plan, how much you want to charge them both monthly and annually. Here you can actually control. Now, Highlevel doesn't do this to you. They don't control the user limit or the contact limit, but if you want to, you can control it for your clients. So you can have a package if you want to that says you can only have on this one right here, for instance, three users on this particular plan. Oh, and if you want more users in the system, so for instance, if you have more salespeople or more technicians or whatever else logging in, they would have to upgrade and buy another plan, a higher plan, that would be unlimited number of users. So you could do that if you want to. It's all a matter of strategy of how you build out your plans, but you can also have a contact limit in here as well. I don't have one set for myself here, but these features, these are all the features of Highlevel that you can simply select. Keep in mind, to select something, you would just need to click on it to highlight it or click on it again to unselect it. Okay, right now, these are some of the other things. If you want to do any of the add-ons, this right here, Highlevel does have a few add-ons for things like WordPress, or if you want to do Yext or WhatsApp, those things can be integrated into your client's account especially for WhatsApp. I know WhatsApp is a great tool, especially for people overseas, because there's a cost difference big time when you're dealing with text messages in remote overseas countries. Sometimes text messaging can be just not a usable feature, which is why WhatsApp is used heavily overseas, and then why in the Americas and Canada, texting is relatively cheap and inexpensive, which is why we text here, even though we can use WhatsApp in the US as well. So these are some of the add-ons. If you want to actually have a trial period, you can have an extended trial period, I think up to 30 days. You can also add credit. So again, we talked about usage for texting, for email, for phone calls, things like that. If you will give your clients a certain amount of money on their plan, just to give them some of it so they're not billed every single month. If they only do a little bit of email, a little bit of texting, then you might be able to give them a credit to use these services every month. And this is how you would sign up and give them the credit. Right now, if you take a look here, I'm gonna move over here. I'm giving $10 a month on this particular plan. So that means after $10 of usage from texting, email, and so forth, I'm gonna give you that for free. Like, I'm gonna pay for that at the agency level. It's included in your plan pricing. And then anything after that, you're gonna pay for. Now, after that, this is where the rebilling comes in. This whole rebilling, by the way, all of these things that you see on the left-hand side, I'm not gonna go through all these. All of these things can be rebilled. Phone system, email, conversation AI, reviews AI. All of these things can be rebilled, meaning notice that you've got this nice little slider here. So you can go anywhere from 1.05 all the way up to 10. And this is what it means. Basically, when you're making a phone call, here's how much Highlevel charges you. This right here is how much based upon your rebilling, depending on the slider. I'm in a 3X here. So I'm charging customers 0.042, which means that I'm making this much, 0.028 per minute, every call from the client, every time they make a call. So this is how I can upcharge, and I can do different amounts. I can have one rebilling for phone, a different rebilling slider number for emails, and maybe nothing for some of these other ones. But the rebilling feature is only available in the SaaS Pro plan. Now just keep in mind, if you have 10 clients, 50 clients, 100 clients, and they're all using email texting every single day, this could lead to hundreds, if not potentially thousands of dollars in usage fees every single month that you get as a part of your plan. Because of course, when you're selling this, you're gonna tell them that, hey, I'm gonna charge you $200 a month and it's gonna cost you 0.042 cents per minute every time you're making a phone call, something like that. So you're gonna definitely give this to your client and be able to sit back and say, hey, these are the charges that I'm gonna charge you for this, which again, I should be very reasonable compared to the normal services, but you're gonna be able to make money off this. But again, you only make money off this if you're at the Agency Pro. Guys, I hope you found out this just quick SaaS review. Hopefully it was informative for you and you got a little bit of information out of it and can accurately choose what type of plan you want to move to, why you would want to move to it, and then how some of the, how you can do some of these features and set up inside of the Highlevel platform. So guys, thanks so much for hanging in there with me. If you have not signed up for Highlevel and looking to get signed up, I do have a 30-day link. Again, you only get 14 days if you go to the website, but with my link, you do get 30 days sign up trial for that, on top of all the other bonuses and coaching and things like that I give, which is huge. But right now, if you've learned anything from this, click on the like button, leave me a comment here. YouTube, actually, I'm doing really great on YouTube, and it's all because of you guys for watching the videos, liking, and commenting. I do appreciate you so much. Thank you so much for hanging in with me, and you guys have a great day. Bye-bye.